So this doping scandal just goes on and on and on. What exactly went wrong in this case?
Plenty, Zane. Yeah, the huge concerns. Remember how we went into the 2016 Summer Games, all those allegations of state-sponsored doping in Russia? The emphasis was on, let's get this right. Let's not have any mistakes. And then came out this 55-page report, and it included many areas of concern. I want to run through just two or three of them. First up, this is really alarming. Many of the athletes that were actually had been targeted for testing during the recent Rio Games simply could not be found. The report also finding there was little or no in-competition blood testing in many of the high-risk sports. And how about this as well? Up to 50% of planned tests simply did not go ahead during the games as well. Really, really areas of concern, issues. Reaction, of course, has been coming in. We did get a statement a little earlier. This is from the Rio 16 local organizing committee, which read, the fight for clean sport is indeed very complex, but WADA has an obligation to be detailed in its work. We made adjustments and evolved during the event. I believe we delivered an excellent Olympic Games. And on top of that, today, Brazil has a very high level of laboratories. Well, certainly not the news that WADA, the World Anti-Doping Agency, wanted to be dealing with at all. There's no question about that. We got some time with the agency's president, Craig Reedy himself. This was his take on it all. Take a listen.
In retrospect, I think if anybody else had been in charge of the testing procedure, they would have had the same logistical difficulties that appeared in Brazil. The one thing that is for sure is that this report will be being studied in almost as we speak in Pyeongchang for the Winter Games of 2018 and certainly in Tokyo for the next Summer Games. Tokyo in particular has a first-class national anti-doping organization. They will be very interested in this, and in particular the several recommendations that were made by the independent observers. And I'm sure many of these will be picked up by the IOC and by the Tokyo organizers in due course.
And that's the other area of concern that, as Sir Craig just mentioned, you know, we've got the Winter Olympic Games taking place in 2018 in South Korea as well. There was some positive news. Just want to try and balance it out just a little bit. Zane WADA also saying the lab was superbly equipped overall, operated very securely and also generally very efficiently as well. So, but the big takeaway on this is, look, lessons have to be learned, and it seems the legacy of the 2016 Rio Summer Games just continues.
So tarnished.
The fallout continues,
so
continuing, alarming in many ways.
All right, Patrick Snell, live for us there. Thank you so much.